Dear students, good morning and welcome back to our practical session on Advanced Food Production 1. Today we will be doing practical number 5. In our last class, we did practical number 4, which consisted of French menu. And today, menu is a mix of dishes from different cuisine. The menu includes cabbage chowder, poulet à la Rex, pommes de Marquise, and ratatouille. We will be starting with cabbage chowder. Talking of chowder is a soup. And soup is a word which is derived from French word soup, which means cooking various ingredients in a bouillon or broth. Specifically talking about soup, it is also believed by some scholars that it is derived from Sanskrit words su and po, which jointly mean to get nourishment. And coming back to chowder is a soup which is believed to be originated in America, but it was brought to America by natives from France and England, which were fishermen. And it is believed that chowder got its names from chaudière, which is a word for the kettle which was used by fishermen to prepare their stew. The ingredients that we will be using in cabbage chowder includes diced cabbage, diced onion, diced tomatoes, bechamel or white sauce, vegetable stock, you can also use chicken stock, salt, pepper, paprika powder, some butter, for garnish, fresh parsley, which is chopped, and a disc which I have made of cheese. We will also be using some cheese grated into the soup. So we'll start by putting a pan on the flame. I'll start. We'll start by adding a little butter. Into the pan. After butter, we will add onions, tomatoes, and cabbage. We'll toss them in the butter nicely till the vegetables get little tender. You can see they are getting tender. Now we'll add some stock in it. And we'll allow it to come to a boil gently. We'll wait till then. Now you can see that it has come to a boil. So we will be adding salt and pepper into it. Salt as per taste, but a standard ratio you can say that it is 2% of the total quantity of the liquid. So here we will be using around 5 grams of salt. Again, pepper is according to taste. Okay, mix it nicely. And for thickening, we will be using white sauce here, bechamel, which you should be knowing is a combination of flour, butter and milk. Okay. But in early recipes, you will also find that while preparing chowder, they used to add butter, flour and milk directly to the stock But here we are mixing by preparing the white sauce, which is bechamel. Okay. So you must also be knowing that chowder is a soup from America. The International Soup of America is clam chowder. So there are various variants of chowder that you can prepare. Well, talking about classification of soups, it come under the category of thick unpassed soups. Okay? So we'll let it again cook for some time. We'll be adding some cheese into it. So I have got here with me processed cheese. We'll use a grater and I will grate cheese into the soup. That should be fine. Again, we will also add some paprika powder. This will give a nice color to our soup. This is a sweet pepper. Again, mix it nicely. Wait for the cheese to melt. Look at the nice color it's having. Balance of colors from tomatoes. Again, let it boil, let it get some thickness and flavors will arise in. Okay? Then we will doing the plating of soup. Okay? So while it's cooking, I will introduce to the plating. So for plating of this soup, we will be using this pasta plate. Okay? We'll take out the nice generous portion of the soup. Okay. The standard portion which is to be served in for one person is approximately 120 ml of soup. Chowder in itself is a complete meal. Okay. You see, we will be garnishing it with a disc of cheese that we have made. We'll put it in the center. Then we will sprinkle some freshly chopped parsley around it. Accompaniment as for any soup you will see is a piece of bread. I've got a toasted bread here. We'll be applying some butter on it. It is toasted bread with some butter. We'll put it on the side of the plate. Voila, cabbage chowder is ready for service to the guest. We'll be moving to our next dish of the menu, which is poulet a la Rex. Rex is a Latin word which means king. So you will also find this dish by the name of poulet a la king. There are various stories that how this dish got its name after the king. The most famous one is from Brighton Beach Hotel. Chef George Greenwald in 1898 prepared this dish and named it after King E. Clark King II and his wife by the chef George Greenwald in 1898. Okay. So basically poulet a la king is a dish which is made of chicken dishes which are cooked in a rich creamy sauce where sometimes you will find the use of sherry and some vegetables like mushroom and capsicum. I will be introducing you to the ingredients that we will be using in the preparation of poulet a la Rex. So the star of the dish is chicken breast, which we will be poaching in stock, dices of mushroom, sauce de velouté, butter, dices of capsicum. I have used all three colors here, red, green and yellow, cooking cream, some fresh herbs, salt, pepper, and stock. So I'll start by boiling the stock. I will put this stock, it is a vegetable stock, on the flame. Okay. We'll heat it up for poaching of chicken breast. So poaching is done on a very, moderate temperature. and it is very difficult to control the temperature of water or stock or any liquid at that level. So what I suggest you that first you bring it to a boil, and after it starts boiling, then you reduce the flame. Okay? So we will bring it to a boil. For boiling water, you will see the bubbles are on the surface of the water. That is a signal that water is boiling and temperature has reached. Okay? So from here, we will reduce the flame. And we will give it a nice stir so that the temperature is distributed evenly. After giving it a nice swirl, you have to remove the bubbles which you see on the bottom of the pan. You will remove those bubbles by stirring it nicely. Okay. Add some salt. Some pepper. Mix it. Now we will be putting breast of chicken in this stock for poaching. Just keep a check that there is no bubble on the surface of the water. Okay. So while our chicken breast is poaching, we will prepare a mixture of cooking cream and egg yolk. We'll mix egg yolk with the cream. Give it a nice whisk. Ready. Okay. So what we will do, we will transfer this to the other range. Now we will need a saucepan here. Okay, I will be using this saute pan. In this pan, we will be sauteing mushroom and capsicum with some butter. We put some butter here. Don't use too much. Be health conscious. So you will see that butter has melted. Now in the melted butter, we will add diced mushroom. After the mushroom, we will add diced capsicum. We will toss it nicely. Now we are going to add some sauce velout in it. Velout is a sauce made by blonde roux and stock. Let it cook. Now to this mixture, we will add the mix of cream and egg yolk that we prepared nicely. And that will help in thickening of the sauce. Keep stirring so that the cream doesn't get curdled. Add some salt and pepper to it. Salt according to taste. But you must remember 2% of the total liquid. Some pepper. Keep the flame on low. Keep your workstation clean. Remove the excess crockery cutlery that you are not using. Take it to the sink. Our chicken breast is also ready. We'll take it out from the poaching liquid. Drain the excess water. Use the yellow chopping board. You can feel the aroma of the stock that is coming. It is so wonderful. So we'll let it cool for some time. Then we'll be cutting it into dices. You can also use the kitchen towel to remove the extra moistness which is there, you can remove it. Okay. Remove the extra moisture. Okay. Put it in the basin. Now you can dice it nicely. Similar way, you will cut the other piece of the chicken breast into dices. Now you can put these pieces into the sauce gravy that is cooking with vegetables. Mix it with the vegetables and sauce that is cooking. Let the chicken also absorb the flavor of stock sauces that is there in the dish. Use a spoon to taste the food, but never taste the food directly from the pan. Okay? You can take a separate bowl or plate. Okay? Take out very little quantity. Okay? Then with the help of a spoon, taste it. And adjust the salt and pepper accordingly. Never use your fingers to taste the food. We need a bit salt in it. It's a little sweet because of cream. Some pepper. Okay. Just mix it well and let it cook for another 2-3 minutes and we'll be ready with Poulet a la Rex. I'll be showing you the presentation of this dish along with the two accompaniments that we will be cooking. The accompaniments are, one is a starch potato dish, which is pommes de marquis, and a vegetable dish, which is ratatouille. So next dish, the accompaniment to our main dish, Poulet a la Rex, is pommes marquis, which is a potato dish. Okay. We will be using mashed potatoes. We have boiled the potatoes, we have mashed them, we are mixing some salt. Some pepper. You can use some fresh herbs, you wish you can use some dry herbs. Give it a nice stir. To make it more smooth, you can add some cream. I am using some cooking cream here. little cream. Again, mix it nicely so that it becomes smooth. Pommes de Marcus actually is a dish in which we pipe this batter into a Volvo shape and then we bake it. Okay. We bake it in a Volvo shape. After the shells are baked, we'll fill those shells with fresh tomato sauce, which we'll be preparing while it is in baking. Okay. So some of the kitchen tools that can come in handy during this time, you can use a roll of the cling film. Take a piping bag. I'm using a disposable piping bag. Put it inside this. Okay. Then roll it over, because at time in the kitchen, you may not find some other person to hold it for you. Okay. Now, you can pour this mixture into this piping bag. Your hands will be clean and whole mixture is in the piping bag. Now, for adding the nozzle, you will use another piping bag. In this bag, you will make a cut with the scissor. Okay. Just make enough cut so the nozzle doesn't drop out of it. Okay. Cut it nicely. Okay. Then take a star nozzle. I'm using star nozzle here. Okay. Put it in the piping bag. Just the tip of the nozzle is getting out. Now, you can make a cut in this bag. Okay. And again, use it here. Okay. Just see, coming out nicely. Remove it. Now, I have a lined baking tray here with me. Okay. In this tray, I'll be arranging the shapes like Volvo. So it will go into a preheated oven now. Okay. Meanwhile, it's baking. We will prepare the sauce that will fill in. Okay. Okay. So while our potato shells are in baking, we'll prepare the sauce that we will fill in. For sauce, I am using some tomato puree. Okay. Finely chopped onions. Fine chopped garlic. Pepper. Salt. Some butter and fine chopped parsley. So we'll start by lighting the gas. Put a pan on the flame, let it dry. Add some butter. Butter is melted. Okay. We'll add in some onions. garlic, let it sweat. Then we will add tomato puree. I am using tomato puree here. Instead, you can use the fresh tomato concasse. We will adjust the seasoning, salt and pepper. Now we'll add some fresh parsley. And our sauce is ready. Then turn off the flame. So the next dish and accompaniment to our main chicken dish is Ratatouille. Name must be sounding familiar. I hope all of you must have watched the movie Ratatouille. Okay? But it is not just a movie. It is a real dish. Okay, which is made by farmers using the fresh summer vegetables. Okay. It is believed that this was originated near the modern day Nice city in France. Okay. And you will find variants of the dish in Spain, Italy and Greece by various names. Okay. Spain you will find it by the name of pisto, Greece you will find it by the name of briami, similar way. But the use of ingredients is quite similar. So I will be introducing you to the ingredients that we will be using in preparation of ratatouille. Okay? So the main ingredients that we use in preparation of ratatouille is called courgettes in French or zucchini in English. We have yellow and green zucchini. We have some eggplants or aubergines which we have sliced. We have some green capsicum, red capsicum, yellow capsicum, some diced onion, some chopped garlic, tomato puree, parsley, salt, and pepper. Okay. So we'll start by putting a pan on the flame, increase the flame. You should use a large pan for this. You'll be tossing the vegetable. It is believed that ratatouille is derived from the French word touiller, which means tossed or stirred. So we will be tossing these vegetables in oil. Okay. So we add oil in a pan. Use generous amount of oil. When oil is hot, add onions, wait for onions to get soft, as onions are getting soft, you can add garlic. You can see how they are sweating, getting nice color. Now you can add some tomato puree in it. Let it cook. Add some salt. Pepper. Reduce the flame a bit. Add all three types of peppers: red, green, and yellow. Stir it nicely. Look at the beautiful color of vegetables here. Now, as the peppers here get tender, we will start adding the courgettes, green and yellow zucchini in it. And the eggplants. Remove the moisture and put it here. Just give it a nice mix. Toss it nicely so that they get mixed. Just splash some water to retain the moistness and allow the vegetables to cook in the steam. You can reduce the flame. And cover it so the steam allows the vegetables to get tender and wait for some time. So I will be presenting the menu of the day in two styles. One is the classic style that you have been seeing, whereas our main dish, which is Poulet a la Rex. It is dices of chicken breast cooked in creamy sauce on the toast. Okay, it can also be served with rice and noodle. Other dish is Pommes de Marquise. We have seen our pommes. We will be filling sauce that we have prepared. Okay, here. Okay, and you can top it with a nice parsley. Okay. And we will be putting the third dish, which is Ratatouille. You can arrange these nice slices of tender vegetables color by color. Here. We'll use some slices of eggplant. We'll take some chunks of vegetables, onion, garlic, and pepper. Top it up nicely. Okay. Again, use some parsley to top it up. Okay. Use kitchen paper towel to clean extra drippings of the sauce from here and there on the plate. So here is the classic presentation of the dish, of a menu. Main course, Poulet a la Rex, which is creamy chicken on the toast. We have Pommes de Marquise, okay, and Ratatouille. I will also be presenting this dish in a modern way. So let's wait and watch. So for modern presentation, I'm using contemporary plate for plating. In this contemporary plate, I will make a base of our first accompaniment, that is ratatouille. Placing some nice slices of vegetables on the base. Then some sauteed other vegetables to balance, making it a nice base. Now on this base, I will put the toast. On the top of the toast, we will be putting our dish of the day, which is poulet a la rex. So poulet a la rex goes in the center. We'll be putting some vegetables along with it, the peppers and mushroom. Red color also. Now on the top, we will be putting a shell of the potato, the Bombs Marquis, and some sauce. You can drip some sauce here, you can rub some sauce along the plate. And garnish it with some parsley. So these are the two presentation styles of the menu that we have prepared today. This one is a contemporary style and this one is a classic style. Okay students, so this is the menu of the day. Starter, cabbage chowder, American soup. Main course I have presented here in two styles. One is the classic style, the main dish on 6, which is poulet a la rex, potato on 10 and vegetables on 2. And I have presented in a classic modern style also. You will see this presentation. I have used ratatouille. In the middle is the main dish, which is poulet a la rex. And I've topped it with the Pommes du Marquis.